Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain knowledge. Muslims are told to say they believe the prophets, but none seem to have any idea what the prophets said. In part one, I touched on several points where Moses described Jesus, or created symbols Jesus would later fulfill. I also mentioned that Job is considered an earlier prophet than Moses. Big round of thanks to Nicer Person for mentioning Job's message. What did Job say as a prophet that pertains to the Messiah? If Job is the earliest scripture of record, then Job was the first to call God our Redeemer. Job 19:25, "As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will take his stand on the earth." Here Job refers to God as my Redeemer. Now, if you call God by a name, or a superlative, or an adjective, you should have some basis, right? Well, what does Redeemer mean? Colloquially, it simply means one who redeems. Okay then, what does redeem mean? If God as Redeemer redeems Job, what does God do? Redeem, definition 1, to buy or pay off, to clear by payment. 2, to buy back, to satisfy an obligation. 3, to recover by payment or other satisfaction. Job, by calling God his Redeemer, says God will do some of these things. This is part of Job's message as a prophet. If you believe Job was a prophet, you should want to learn several things. Did any other prophets also reveal God is their Redeemer? Did they call God Redeemer? Also, how did the prophets reveal that God would redeem them and anyone else? So did any other prophets also reveal God is their Redeemer? Did they call God Redeemer? Psalm 19:14, "Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Yahweh, my strength and my Redeemer." Prophet David in the Psalms calls Yahweh God my Redeemer. Psalm 78:35, "And they remembered that God was their rock, the High God, their Redeemer." So more than once, Prophet David called God Redeemer. Proverbs 23:11, "For their Redeemer is mighty, he shall plead their cause with thee." Prophet Solomon calls Yahweh God their Redeemer, speaking of Israel. Isaiah 41:14, "Fear not, thou worm Jacob, and you men of Israel, I will help thee, saith the Lord, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel." Prophet Isaiah calls Yahweh God thy Redeemer. 43:14, "Thus saith the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel." This is how Isaiah introduces God. 44:6, "This is what the Lord, Yahweh, says, the King of Israel and its Redeemer. The Lord of the heavenly armies is his name. I am the first and I am the last, and apart from me there is no God." 47:4, "As for our Redeemer, the Lord Yahweh of hosts is his name, the Holy One of Israel." Over and over, Prophet Isaiah calls Yahweh Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Jeremiah 50:34, "Their Redeemer is strong. The Lord Yahweh of hosts is his name. He shall thoroughly plead their cause, and he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon." So prophets Job, David, Solomon, Jeremiah, and Isaiah all reveal God is their Redeemer. It is clear from the message of the prophets, God will redeem us from something. The obvious question then is, what will God redeem us from? Prophet Isaiah addresses that issue. 44:22, "I have wiped out your transgressions like a thick cloud, and your sins like a heavy mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you." From this verse, there are two things we should particularly notice. God says he has wiped away our transgressions and sins, and describes it as have redeemed you. So redeeming us is to buy us back from our obligation, which God identifies as our sins, our transgressions. Second, notice has and have are past tense. This is something God has already done. Part of the message of the prophets is that Yahweh God loves us first. God does something for us first. This is what the prophets referred to down through the ages, the forgiveness of sins, God forgiving us. But, and this is important to notice, God forgives us first. In 44:22, it ends by saying, "Return to me, for I have redeemed you." This aspect of the gospel is often underemphasized and misunderstood, and it is a core piece of the gospel of Yeshua, the Messiah. God loved us first, so God redeemed us before we turned to him. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that everyone who believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." God gave first because he loved us first. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. God gave Yeshua to redeem us from our sins, to save us. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is already condemned. We are about to learn what still condemns us. Because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. And this is the verdict, or the condemnation. The light has come into the world, but men loved darkness more than light, because their deeds were evil. Not a light, but the light. John 8:12. Then Jesus again spoke to them, saying, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." So 3:19 says, "And this is the verdict, or the condemnation. The light has come into the world, but men loved darkness more than light, because their deeds were evil." This indicates men are condemned for their love of darkness. Everyone who does evil hates the light and does not come into the light for fear that his deeds will be exposed. You will have to humble yourself to come to the light. Our deeds must be exposed, for all have sinned. Now the prophets said Yahweh God would redeem them, as I have shown. And then the prophets revealed the following as well. Isaiah 53:8, "By oppression and judgment he was taken away. And as for his generation, who considered that he was cut off out of the land of the living for the transgression of my people, to whom the stroke or the punishment was due?" Prophet Isaiah reveals Messiah will be killed for the sins or the transgressions of God's people. Remember, the prophets said Yahweh is the Redeemer, but it is Messiah who is paying the price for us. Colossians 2:12, "He erased the certificate of debt with its obligations that was against us and opposed us, and has taken it out of the way by nailing it to the cross." 1 Corinthians 15:3, "For what I received I passed on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures," meaning according to the message of the prophets. Galatians 3:13, "Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone who is hanging on a tree. 2 Corinthians 5:21. God made him, meaning Messiah, who knew no sin, to be sin on our behalf, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Ephesians 1:7. In him, Messiah, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses and sins, according to the riches of his grace. Colossians 1:14, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. See, here it's clear. God redeemed us, meaning he forgave our sins, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of his cross. Remember, the prophets said Yahweh is the Redeemer. Yeshua the Messiah fulfilled this with his death on the cross. Titus 2:14, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness, and to purify for himself a people for his own possession, who are zealous for good works. Pay close attention, because Messiah redeemed us for himself. That implies Messiah is God, Yahweh, come in the flesh. And I think that should be the topic of the next video. God would come in the flesh. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.